Welcome to Together at Hanukkah. It's time to light the candles and get out the latkes, as tonight 18 artists from around the world will perform for you to celebrate Jewish life and raise money for the MDA. We hope you'll enjoy the show.
To life! To life! L'chaim! 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 To life! Life has a way of confusing us, blessing and bruising us. Drink l'chaim to life! God would like us to be joyful, even when our hearts lie panting on the floor. How much more can we be joyful, even when there's something to be joyful for? To us and our good fortune, and be happy, be healthy, long life! And
hello, everyone. My name is Dannii Cohen. Welcome to Together at Hanukkah, a celebration of love and light for the Jewish community. And more importantly, a fundraiser for the MDA, the Israeli Paramedic Organization. When October the 7th happened, I was, just like all of you, lost. Not sure what to do, how to help, but knowing that I wanted to do something. We all felt that. And because we all felt this, we all started reaching out to each other around the world, because we, the Jewish community, are a big family around the world, wherever we are, whoever we are. We are part of a family. And that feeling was something I wanted to work with. And being the host of a radio show called Behind the Mirror Music, a show about art, theater, musical theater, I knew that perhaps this was something I could work with. So when I knew that this was what I could do, I soon contacted artists around the world and asked them if they wanted to contribute to this project. And all of them said yes immediately, because they too felt that connection. And so I hope you enjoy this night. Happy Hanukkah, everyone.
Hi everyone, I'm Estee Stimler, book writer lyricist, and I'm here speaking to you on behalf of Stand With Us UK. Magen David Adom spends every single day helping injured and wounded, sometimes at great cost to their lives. Please be generous and donate. Thank you so much and have a happy Hanukkah.
Please visit behindthemirrorofmusic.com to find out all the info on how to donate. Our first artist tonight is Eytan Freeman. Eytan has been a beloved star of the stage for over 40 years. His credits include being the first Jewish actor in history to perform the role of the Phantom in The Phantom of the Opera, performing the role on West End and also in Toronto, Vienna and Germany, and being chosen by Disney to originate the role of the Beast for Disney's Beauty and the Beast European premiere, making him the first Jewish Disney prince. In recent years, he has also become known for another art form, painting. Since October, he has used this medium to fundraise for the MDA, donating the money for every painting sold to the charity. Tonight, Eytan will perform the song that is the theme of our show, No One Is Alone, by Stephen Sondheim.
Mother cannot guide you, now you're on your own. Only me beside you, still you're not alone. No one is alone, truly no one is alone. Sometimes people leave you may deceive you. You decide what's good. You decide alone. But no one is alone. People make mistakes. Fathers, mothers, people make mistakes. Holding to their own. thinking they're alone. Honor their mistakes. Everybody makes one another's terrible mistakes. Witches can be right. Giants can be good. You decide what's right. You decide what's good. Just remember, someone is on your side. Someone else is not. While we're seeing our side, maybe we forgot they are not alone. No one is alone. Hard to see the light now. Just don't let it go. Things will turn out right now. Right now, we can make it so. Someone is on your side. No one is alone.
Next up is Avi Hoffman. Avi is a world-famous actor known for Magic City, Bloodline and Graceland, among many others, who specializes in Jewish culture and Yiddish theater. His long-running Two Jewish trilogy has been seen by millions on PBS and in venues around the world. He is also CEO at Yiddishkeit Initiative and Love Jewish.
The Miracle by Philip M. Raskin. The rabbi tells his old, old tale, the pupils seated round. And thus, my boys, no holy oil in the temple could be found. The heathens left no oil to light the Lord's eternal lamp. At least one jar, one single jar was found with the high priest's stamp. Its oil could only last one day, but God hath wondrous ways. For lo, a miracle occurred, it burned for 8 whole days. The tale was ended, but the boys, all open-eyed and dumb, sat listening still, as though aware of stranger things to come. Just wait, my boys, permit me, pray, the liberty to take. Your rabbi, may he pardon me, has made a slight mistake. Not 8 days, but 2,000 years that jar of oil did last. To quell its wondrous flames availed no storm, no flood, no blast. But this is not yet all, my boys. The miracle just starts. This flame is kindling light and hope in countless gloomy hearts. And in our long and starless night, lest we should go astray, it beacon-like sheds floods of light and eastward points the way. Where light will shine on Zion's hill, as in the days of old, the miracle is greater, boys, than what your rabbi told.
Hi, everybody. I'm Michael Garin. Here's my Hanukkah song. When the days grow short and the nights grow cold and it's holiday time at home, those memories of childhood are where I long to roam. This special song for a special time brings back that special joy. Its message still is true today for every girl and boy. Hooray for Hanukkah! Let's play the trumpet and harmonica. And let's remember Mr. Mattathias. He had a bias against the worship of clay. And oh, the oil was oh so loyal. It lasted for a week and an extra day. Hooray for Hanukkah! When Jews from Brooklyn to Salonika Recall a Maccabean tale of glory. It's quite a story. It makes you glad it's today. But pure delirium, we're not in Syria. Hooray for Hanukkah. Hooray for Hanukkah. Where everybody and Veronica can rest assured that mean old Antiochus and Hocus Pocus were surely destined to flop. So have a latke and a shot of vodka, cause Judah Maccabeus ended up on top. Hooray for Hanukkah. From Tel Aviv to Santa Monica, menorahs get lit up in celebration of liberation. Our people are finally free. Another happy feast from the Middle East. Hooray for Hanukkah. I'm Yisrael Chai. Have a great holiday.
Hi, I'm Rosa. Magen David Adom is working to help injured and wounded people day and night, round the clock. Please help them help others. Go to behindthemirrorofmusic.com and donate, please.
Joining us is Leon Gurvitch. Leon is a Bernstein-inspired, award-winning pianist, composer, and conductor who specializes in creating work with Jewish themes. Leon is one of today's leading Jewish composers, and most recently his concert Their Voices Will Remain was live-streamed during Jewish Remembrance Week. He will perform a special piece dedicated to Israel. Thank you. Joining us is Daniella Rabbani. Daniella is an American actress, singer and voiceover artist. She has appeared in a number of films and television shows, including Ocean's 8, God Friended Me, The Americans, Appropriate Behavior, Floating Sunflowers, Bridge and Tunnel and Loves. Daniella has also worked extensively with the National Yiddish Theatre Volksbühne, most recently in Amid Falling Walls, a production that used Yiddish songs from the Holocaust to show how Jews treasured life amid terrible suffering.
Hanukkah, oh Hanukkah, come light the menorah. Let's have a party, we'll all dance the hora. Gather around the table, we'll give you a treat. Sivivon to play with and latkes to eat. And while we are playing, the candles are burning low. One for each night, they share their sweet light to remind us of days long ago. Share their sweet light to remind us of days long ago.
Yemei Hanukkah, Hanukkat Mikdashenu, Begilu v'simcha memalim et libeinu. Laila v'yom svivoneinu isov, Sufganiyot nochal gam larov. Ayiru adliku nerot Hanukkah rabim, al hanisim ve'al hanifloot asher.
Hanukkah, Hanukkah, Yom Tov Hashener, a lustiger, a freilich in it ono chazener. Alle Nacht in der Edel spielen wir, nu frische heiße Latkes essen wir. Geschwindert, zind kindert, Hanukkah lichtelechon, soll jeder besonder, was singen dem Wunder, tanzen der freilich im Korn. Besonder, was singen dem Wunder, tanzen freilich im Korn.
Our little tune for you and Nigendal. We sing it in Naches, when we're proud, and in Frieden, when we're happy, in Mazel, in good times, and in Brucha, and in blessings. We sing it together, zusammen, all of us. The Tate Mame, the parents, the Baba Zeide, our grandparents, the ganze Mishpuche. We sing this little tune. And according to the Hasidim, according to the folklore of Yiddish music, when life is so big, so great, so happy, so sorrowful, sometimes words, even Yiddish words, yes, it's true, suffice. They don't suffice, rather. They're just not enough. We need the tune, the niggin, the biddy bye bye, ya ba bye bye, ya ba bi bye bi bum 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 bum. So I ask you, from where you're sitting, go ahead and join me. I'll repeat the tune, the niggin, several times. And sing with us, sing with me, sing with the many, many generations of Yidden who sang together. Das hat noch gesungen, die Puppe mit dem Fell.
Kanderlach gewein. Oi, 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 o da zoim, je wie der Dig klingt zinder. Az a freilach sind je Kinder hot. A zoim, je wie der Dig klingt zinder. Az a freilach slo mir alle gein. Oi, 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 dai, dararai, 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 dai, dai, ai, bai, bai. As a freilich slo mir alle gein. Oi, 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 ho mir anin. Doch in Masel und in Bruche, in Masel und in Bruche, singen mir es, bei dies mir es, klingt es also schön. Das hat noch gesungen der Tate mit der Mühe. Oi, wenn sie seinen Kindern noch gewinnen. Ai, 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 da sei je wie der Nickel. Singen wir zusammen, singen wir zusammen, singen wir es bei dies, wir es klingt es so schön. Das wird noch gesungen, die ganze Mischbuche, heute sie sehen, Kinderlach gewinnt. Oi, 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 das sei, der wieder nicht klingt das Zunder. Als er freilich sich schick in der Rote, das sei, der wieder nicht klingt das Zunder. Als er freilich slow wir alle gehen. Oi, 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 dai, da, 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 da. Da 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 da.
Joining us is Rachel Creeger. Rachel is a multi-award-winning stand-up comedian, writer and director, plus the only practicing Orthodox Jewish woman on the mainstream UK comedy circuit. She is co-host of chat show podcast Jew Talking to Me, a regular guest on BBC London Radio, and resident MC for Comedy Upstairs at the Adam and Eve. Tonight, Rachel will perform her specially written Hanukkah monologue.
Hello, I'm comedian Rachel Creeger, and I'm really excited to talk to you about this because I've always been a massive fan of Hanukkah. I mean, 8 days of donuts, what's not to like? I know for some, it's the thrill of the presents, whether that's 8 small gifts or 1 large one. And for others, it's the joy of lighting candles. You know, as a kid, that chance to play with fire with your parents' permission. You show me that child who hasn't had fun dripping the wax somewhere they weren't meant to. And then as you get a bit older, I love those arguments with friends about what exactly constitutes the perfect latke. Is it simply a fancy name for a hash brown? Do you use just potato or potato and egg? Do you throw in an onion? I once shared the most controversial recipe of all, my grandmother's matzah meal latke recipe, a batter with no potato at all that you serve with sugar and cinnamon. I'm picturing your horrified faces now. Even my husband's probably screaming inside, but we call those bubbelers, they're for Pesach. Take it from me, matzah meal latkes rock, they are worth every calorie. But I'm a showbiz lovey, so when I was growing up, it wasn't just the smell of the grease or the roar of the fryer, it was all about the Hanukkah concerts. Whether they were in the synagogue hall or school or a JCC, those shows were the highlight of my year. Even Purim couldn't hold a candle to them. You'd head out in your costume on a dark winter's night, it seemed like the height of glamour. And the building would have been decorated and cheerful, while the Ladies Guild or Parent Teachers Association or volunteers would have arranged treats and activities, dreidel spinning for the kids and something more grown up like roulette for the adults. Same, same, but different, I suppose. And before that, we would get to perform. You remember those glittering productions where as small children, we would proudly hold aloft a silver foil covered cardboard sword and shield that would have been about as much use to a Maccabee as a silver foil covered cardboard sword and shield. but the show has brought everyone together, every generation, to celebrate our survival. Not just at the hands of the ancient Syrian Greeks, but the teachers who'd survived the nightmare-inducing rehearsal period, and the parents who'd survived our pre-show emotional roller coasters. The relief was palpable, on all counts. A few years ago, one of the Jewish high schools asked me to help them casting their Hanukkah show. And what was amazing to me was how all of the students treated it like they were contestants on Britain's Got Talent. Each one wanted to share their painful backstory about how they had a sore throat that we had to take into consideration, and how they weren't even going to audition, but then their grandma filled in the application form just before she died. So they're doing this for her. And then they would immediately launch into a version of Defying Gravity, so shrill that I'd want to hurl myself off the stage. It was so draining that the next day I was very tempted to stand up before we started and tell them that I had a bad migraine from the previous auditions. And although it might affect my judging of their abilities, they had to take that into consideration, and I was just going to give it 110% and really make it my own. And it's a funny time of the year for me, because while I love Hanukkah, like a lot of Jews, I also secretly love Christmas. We weren't always a religious family, but we never celebrated it other than the occasional 25th of December, when my mum would cook an ironic turkey just for fun, with coincidental cranberry sauce just for fun. And sometimes we'd pull crackers too, because they're fun. Well, they're fun for 50% of the people, aren't they? The winners. But it was like there was an arbitrary line in the sand. I mean, my grandma used to take us up to London's West End to sit on Santa's knee in Santa's grotto, and that was okay. But writing Santa a letter to ask for specific presents, that was a step too far. I actually remember that for three consecutive years, I got terrible presents from the grotto. Initially, I just assumed it was because I was Jewish. But the next time it happened, I wondered if it was because Santa had never had an actual letter from me. By the following year, I'd worked it out. I'd realised, I'm just a very naughty girl. There's something magical and glittery about Christmas, though. When my husband and I were first married, we went to live and work in Minsk in Belarus. You know, like Phoebe's boyfriend David in Friends. He lived quite near to us, but he wasn't anywhere near as involved in the Jewish community. I'm not judging, I'm just saying. When we moved into our flat, though, it was so romantic, and we immediately did what any newlywed young couple in love would do on arrival in their first proper home, which is that we checked out all of the cupboards to see if the previous residents had left anything interesting. And as I was poking around, I found something bizarre and kind of wonderful. Inside one of the hall cupboards was a small artificial Christmas tree, complete with tinsel and baubles and lights and a star. It was so exciting. It meant that any time I had a Yuletide craving, I could open that cupboard, stick my head inside and sing a little carol to myself. It was like I could have Christmas, but only in Narnia. I do love Hanukkah, especially donuts, as you can probably tell. Some time ago, my auntie Sheila and I were at a Hanukkah party for our family, and we were both watching a cousin of ours who was dancing, and she'd lost loads of weight and she looked fantastic. And my auntie said to me, you know what? Anyone could go on a diet and look like that, but to maintain a body like ours, that takes daily effort. I remember I was asked to host Hanukkah in the Square, a huge event in central London, and the organisers emailed me to check if I had any special requests for my rider. And I replied that I'd heard something about them supplying free donuts. They emailed me back and said, don't worry, there'll be as many donuts as you could possibly eat. And I replied, challenge accepted, because I have been training for this 8 days a year for literally my whole life. In fact, if you're wondering how old I am, I've eaten a minimum of 368 donuts so far this Hanukkah. I actually have to be quite careful about which donuts I buy, because as well as keeping kosher, I have a ton of allergies and intolerances. We can assume that if I so much as went near a shellfish, I'd go into anaphylactic shock long before God could strike me down with a bolt of lightning. That's one of the reasons why I hate it when the media uses Jews as political prawns. The only thing I have left to spark joy in my life is gluten. if a doctor said to me, and I mean an actual medical doctor, not a member of my family who knows how to use Google, but if a professional medical doctor said that I had to give up gluten, and I'm talking no more challah bread on a Friday night, no more donuts on Hanukkah, no more little pastries called something in Yiddish with the word chuch in the middle, I'd probably eat a handful of peanuts and let the chips fall as they may. By the way, I'm also allergic to latex, which some people find quite funny, but is far less of a problem for an Orthodox Jew. I'll just let you sit with that for a second. The other big focus of this season is, of course, presents, like I said at the beginning. I am the world's newest grandmother. I assume you're saying mazel tov, thank you very much. I mean, there probably have been other babies born over the past year, but none of them were as important as this one. I imagine Mary and Joseph's mothers felt exactly the same. So then you come to that traditional dilemma. Do you get them one big present or eight small presents? I'll tell you what, why don't you play this to your children or grandchildren and tell them that this is their present? You're welcome. Joking apart though, our community pressurises us to buy multiple gifts, but I think that's a terrible idea. I mean, we all hope to live for a very long time, and these gestures really add up. Imagine if you saved all of that money. Someday there might be something really meaningful that you want to spend it on. For example, what if one of you wants to do an Edinburgh Fringe Festival show? We all want to treat our loved ones, but you need something thoughtful and personal and cheap. And homemade presents are the best, aren't they? Because the person has to like them because you made it. They can't take them back to the shop. They can't re-gift them to someone else. In fact, last summer, my husband and I celebrated our pearl wedding anniversary. So, of course, I wanted to give him a present that was thoughtful and personal and cheap. So what I did was to make him something myself, something special. What I did was I wrote him a joke. There is a joke in one of my sets that's dedicated to him, to my husband. It really bigs him up, and I'll be telling it for the entirety of our 30th year of marriage. And he can't take it back to the shop or re-gift it to someone else. In many ways, it's the perfect present. In 2017, at the Edinburgh Fringe Festival, one of my friends decided it would be fun to run a sort of ironic Christmas gig all through the month of August down in a basement bar in the New Town. It was complete with a tree and mince pies and mulled wine. My dream come true. He used to invite me in a couple of times a week to do a little bit about Hanukkah, which was always good fun. And on one particular occasion, I think it was maybe the second time in the second week, I was waiting in the wings for him to introduce me. And he said to the audience, "Are you ready for your next act?" And they said, "Yes." He said, "Are you ready for some real diversity?" And they said, "Yes." And he said, "Welcome to the stage, Jewish comedian Rachel Creeger." And the whole front row booed. I was really shocked. I hadn't even told them a joke yet. But everyone froze, horrified. And I thought, wow, is this proper anti-Semitism here at the most international arts festival in the world? And then I realised that maybe I was being a bit hasty. Maybe I was judging them a bit too harshly. Perhaps when he announced real diversity, they were expecting the dance troupe diversity, a group of seven athletic young black men who'd appeared on Britain's Got Talent doing backflips and acrobatics to music. Either way, they were going to be disappointed, weren't they? But the truth was that the joke was on them because they were trapped in the front row, so they still had to listen to me banging on about Hanukkah for 8 minutes, which was a miracle because I only had enough material for 1 minute. Wishing us all peace. Happy holidays. Chag Sameach.
Hello, I'm singer-songwriter Eytan Mirsky. The MDA, Magen David Adom, are working around the clock to help the injured and wounded, sometimes at great risk of their lives. Please help them help others. Visit behindthemirrorofmusic.com and donate. Thank you. Chai v'rei
Shalom Bach Leman Beit Hashem Elokeinu. Dabrana, dabrana, shalom bach, leman achai v'reai, leman achai v'reai, dabrana, dabrana, shalom. Shemelokeinu avak shatov lach leman bet Shemelokeinu avak shatov lach leman bet Shemelokeinu avak shatov lach.
Joining us for two songs tonight are Shimi Goodman and Christopher Hamilton, a.k.a. piano and tenor duo Tiano. Shimi is also a star of the West End, appearing in numerous shows. The duo will be performing a song from their latest album Tiano, and later return with a Hanukkah medley.
This next song, earlier this year, I just woke up in the middle of the night and I basically saw the whole song in front of me. That's never happened to me before. So I had the whole idea, the melody and the lyrics, and I just jotted a few words and a few notes on my pad next to my bed. And
always good to have a pad next to your bed.
It is.
For that eventuality.
Exactly. Don't forget that. And then in the morning, I woke up. I was a little bit tentative, but I asked Chris what he thinks about this song.
I know, he's always a bit scared of my response. I don't know why, because I was actually very impressed. I said, well, firstly, forget it being a solo, we're gonna do it as a duet. I want in. So we collaborated, and we hope you like it. We've only done it once, actually, live before. It pretty much summed up how we were feeling at the beginning of the year.
So this is called, thank you, A Better Day.
Such peculiar times. Now we're stuck here at home, when the world used to be our oyster. On the one hand, it feels like an overdue pause. On the other, it's far from ideal. I have plenty to say, though my words seem cliched. Does anything really matter? But as long as I'm playing piano with you, I'm happy. It seems
whether words can convey what I'm feeling inside is a matter that's so far beyond me. On the one hand, it feels like the end of the world. On the other, I'm so full of dreams. I have nothing to say. What's the point of this song? Will anyone ever listen? But as long as I'm singing with you next to me, I'm happy, it seems. So play.
better day.
In a few years from now, we'll look back on these days, a collection of bittersweet memories.
A year that we lost, or a year that we gained, a conclusion that's far from foregone. Once we stepped off this bizarre carousel, there may be a new beginning. But if it doesn't stop turning round and round, we'll still sing our song. So play with me until the end of time. Though here and now, there is no reason nor rhyme. A better day. Together we can survive a world that's lost its way. Music can heal the things we conceal and make it a better day.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Joining us is Shachar Don Levy. Shachar has used her position as influencer and comedian to spread the truth about Israel and debunk media lies. She has strengthened our spirit during dark days and educated many people with her mix of humor and facts. She will now join us for an interview.
I've been creating content for many, many years, but I've been doing it for work for the past 3 years. And it mostly started actually when TikTok became viral. I kind of tried it out and I went viral there. And then during the war, I kind of moved from my regular content creation to war-based content because I can't make content about anything else at the moment. Even if I could, it doesn't feel right. It's what I do full time. It's my work. I'm freelance. I really enjoy it. I didn't expect it to go so viral. It's been worldwide and it's actually, I'm surprised it's working. At first I thought it was like, you know, just the Jewish community cares, but I get so many messages from non-Jewish people, from people who've changed their mind, from Muslims who support us. It's insane. I didn't think it would be that viral, but yeah, there's videos with millions of views, like millions. I tried to go with the approach of A, being like humorous, and B, maybe even a bit tactless. Like, I don't care about saying maybe things that are a little bit problematic because I live in Israel and I can talk about the conflict. And I also have a lot of knowledge on the subject, especially now because I've been researching so much. I wanted to say that because I'm liberal. I'm very liberal, and I'm surprised by how my liberal friends outside were just completely went to the other side. It was insane to me. Yeah, and it also taught me that it's okay not to agree with everyone on everything. I've made new friends that I don't agree with most things about, but in this specific, in the fact that I deserve to live, they agree with me, so I like them. I think it's the most Jewish thing ever, and I think it's one of the reasons we're surviving all the time. I genuinely think it keeps us alive. I was just talking about it on my story. Some of the people that were hostages that came out, the teenagers, have been making funny videos joking about their experience as hostages. And I'm like, wow, these 16-year-olds have been 51 days in Gaza and in tunnels, and they're joking about it because that's how they're dealing with it. I think it's incredible. I wanted to say something about the amount of hate I get, because I get a lot of death threats and a lot of hate. Like, it's almost become like a normal thing. But I'm also overwhelmed by the amount of love and support that we're getting from all around the world. It's very easy to focus on the hatred and the death threats, But we have people supporting us in every single country in the world, Dannii. I've gotten messages from the weirdest places, from Papua New Guinea, from Syria, from Lebanon, like craziest messages. There are lots of good people out there that know to be on the right side of history. I think this is the first time that I felt that my content is more, like, I used to make nonsense content the same as I do now, but less of, like, there wasn't a point to it. And now I feel like it's actually making a difference of some sort. So I try and remind myself of that every day.
Joining us is David Serero. David is an award-winning singer, producer, director, and writer. His most recent production was the revival of Anne Frank, a musical. Paramedic organization is working around the clock, day and night, under very difficult circumstances, being there for everyone in Israel, sometimes at risk of their own lives. If you can, please donate. Joining us is Rebecca Wicking. Rebecca is a star of the stage Into the Woods, Rent, Hair, A Midsummer Night's Dream, and Annie Get Your Gun. She's also head of musical theater at the City Academy. Her album, Because I'm Rebecca Wicking, was a stage music bestseller.
Of things I should be thankful for, goodly share. And as I sit here in the comfort of a cozy chair, my fancy takes me to a humbly sight tenement, three flights up to the rear, to where my childhood days were spent. It wasn't much like paradise, but midst the dirt and all, there sat the sweetest angel, one that I fondly call my Yiddish mama. I need her more than ever now, my Yiddish mama. I'd like to kiss her.
Joining us is Ori Dagan. Ori is an award-winning jazz singer-songwriter based in Toronto, Canada. He has released 4 studio albums, including Click Right Here.
Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by if you smile through your fear and sorrow. Smile, maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you. Light up your face with gladness, hide every trace of sadness, although a tear may be ever so near. That's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll see that life is still worthwhile if only you smile. Light up your face with gladness, hide every trace of sadness, although a tear may be ever so near. That's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll see that life is still worthwhile if only you smile.
Chag Sameach.
Joining us is Rosa de Vries, Israeli blogger and integral therapist. Rosa will give us an update on how life in Israel has been since October 7.
Good morning from Israel, the center from Israel. My name is Rosa and I live in Israel for about 6 years. I'm originally Dutch. I came from Amsterdam. 6 years ago I made Aliyah, and that was the best thing I could ever do for myself. Being a Jew and hearing stuff that's going on right now, I wouldn't have felt safe there. And now I'm safe. And I think everybody thinks this woman is crazy, but it's how I feel. Until the October 7, we woke up early in the morning, 6:20, and there was alarm. And alarm means rockets. Rockets mean running. So I ran to my children, took my dog, put something on, and we went downstairs to the Miglat. The Miglat is the safe room. But the alarm was going and going and going. So I saw in an app I have that it was like almost full-time alarm and full-time rockets all over our country. And then around in about 10:30, we heard about the atrocities in the south, about the party, the Nova party, about the women that got raped, about the people that were shot. And we heard about the kibbutzim and the moshavim. They were all attacked. And I think it was the worst day of our lives. And until now, our life has changed a lot, really a lot. Smiling is not going full. We're trying to, we cope, but it's hard, really hard. I want to tell you about this organization, Magen David Adom, our ambulances and the guys that really, really worked so hard that specific 7th of October. And until now, there's still people that get into accidents because of the rockets, because of the falling shrapnels, they call it, or the shells. And if we didn't have the Magen David Adom, if we didn't have the Iron Dome, if we didn't have our people in Israel, there was no Israel anymore. So we need Magen David Adom, and I want to ask you to please send us some money, send them the money, so they can keep on doing the good work. And we will be safer without them. Then without them. Sorry for this. Okay, I want to show you a little bit of Israel. This is my neighborhood. This is where I live. It's gorgeous. It's different. It's right over here. So, do you want to keep it? Do we want to be the Israelis we are? We have to make sure that this life will be full of crazy people.
just like to wish you good holidays, enjoy, and just think of us now and then.
Joining us is Shura Lepowski, a highly valued performer of Yiddish song on the international stage. She's also a writer and composer of new Yiddish songs, and she appears worldwide as a singer and storyteller. Tonight, she performs one of her own compositions, dedicated to Israel.
Der Mach, als ist nicht da, wenn teure Menschen verschwinden in Grau, Epistel weht in seine edle Brust und es klebt da drin und es weht da. As a man shall come and bring an interest on the morning's lumen, a titan in a gaten, where keiner versteht, wie a male muss leiden, wenn kommt all so spät, but are there alle. As a man shall come and bring an interest on the morning's lumen, a titan in a gaten, where keiner versteht, wie a man muss leiden, wenn kommt an zu spät, schämt sich der Mann. As er ist nicht da, wenn Teile der Menschen verschwinden in Grau, ist der Wind in seine edle Brust und es klebt das Werk und es wehtigt der Post. Madonna, wir allein aus dem Mann soll kommen. Wenn kommt dann zu spät, was war für allein, als ein Mann soll kommen und bringen im Triest und am Morgen sein Lohnen, was Typen ihm geben, weil keiner versteht, wie ein Mann muss leiden, wenn kommt um zu spät. Schämt sich der Mann, als ist nicht da, wenn teure Menschen verschwinden in Grau. Ist der Wind in seine edle Brust und es klebt der Tränen und es wehtigt der Brust. Malach muss leiden, wenn kommt um zu spät.
Joining us is David Rhodes. Rhodes' work as a solo artist, stage, film and television actor have garnered critical acclaim nationally and internationally. He also toured an array of successful solo musical tours, including most recently, Does Anyone Still Finish? Ahead, a tribute to Stephen Sondheim.
There was a boy, a very strange, enchanted boy. They say he wandered very far, very far, over land and sea. A little shy and sad of eye, but very wise was he. And then one day, one magic day, he passed my way. And while we spoke of many things, fools and kings, this he said to me: the greatest thing you'll ever learn is just to love and be loved in return. Thing you'll ever learn is just to love and be loved in return.
Thank you.
Joining us is Heather Klein, a soprano, cantorial soloist, songwriter, producer, and beloved Yiddish chanteuse.
Freilich and Hanukkah. I am so thrilled to be with you tonight. This amazing tune, Zeit Gesund, which I first heard sung by Theodore Bekel. Last year, my dear friend, cantor Becky Kitchrick and I put together some English words around the time of Hanukkah. So I thought I would sing that for you today.
Seid gesund, morgen vor euch ob. Hab schein euch genäht, ha säckel, ob geschert im Kopf. Hab a kommen schein gattel, zog a neid beim Kät. On sich schein mit alle Schreinem durch der Wand zu stehen. Ai, 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 farewell, my friends, farewell, my friends. The journey still goes on. The nights are long, the days are short. We yearn for those who've gone. Dark days soon will be a memory, giving way to light. Rededicate to one another these candles shining bright.
I'm Adam B. Shapiro. I'm a singer and an actor, particularly in the Yiddish theater. The MDA, Magen David Adom, are working around the clock.
Von der Weiten ist grün und bläu die Welt und die Berge lech schneeweiß. Von der Weiten zerfließt der Teich von Feld und der Odler flieht mit Weiß. Von der Weiten klingt Harmonie und sie hilft dort durch ein Land. Sie ist doch Hoffnungskohl, sie ist doch Scholemskohl, sie ist das Kohl von jedem Mann. Von der Weitens haben alle genug und keine ist in Neut. Und mit kein Wolf vom es mal geht euch und keine darf abbreut. Von der Weitens nur ein Kapelle, wir marschieren zum selben Volk. Es klappt der Hoffentat, es klappt der Scholentat, es klappt das Herz von jeder Freund. Der Beure guckt davon, der Beuge guckt auf uns, der Beuge guckt auf uns von der Weiten. Von der Weiten sehst du euch, mein Freund, Hagam, es geht a Krieg. Von der Weitens frag ich, war was bis mein Feind, was ist umkum und was ist sieg. Von der Weitens klingt Harmonie, Hoffnung hat Sinn, sie ruft Liebe hat Sinn, in dem Herz von jedem Kind. Mein Kohl mit Hoffnung wünscht, dein Kohl mit Liebe wünscht, das ist die Brache von jedem Mensch. Herr Boy, der Beure guckt auf uns von der Weitens. Der Beure guckt auf uns, der Beure guckt auf uns, der Beure guckt
Now, welcome back Shimi Goodman and Christopher Hamilton with a happy Hanukkah medley.
So in order to rededicate the temple, they had to illuminate it. Rededication is the meaning of the word Hanukkah. That's why we call it Hanukkah. It's rededication of the temple. So they had to illuminate the temple. And how will they do it? They only had one little oil lamp that should last one day. But it lasted 8 days. A miracle. That's why it's the festival of lights and miracles. And that's why we celebrate it for 8 days. And we give a gift. In Israel, we give a gift to all the kids on the first day. But in America, they made it even more fun. They give 8 gifts. One gift for every day.
I'm converting.
So tonight, we, for our 8th number in the show, listen to this, the 8th number in the show, we created an 8-minute medley of 8 Jewish musical icons for you.
I know.
How about that? Starting with the divine Miss M, the queen of comedy, or Bette Midler. It must have been cold there in my shadow to never have sunlight on your face. You were content to let me shine. That's your way. You always walked a step behind. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I would like to be. I can fly higher than an eagle. You are the wind beneath my wings.
Now, did you know that Bette Midler started her career in a gay sauna in New York? And was often accompanied by our next Jewish icon,
Mr. Barry Manilow.
You came along just like a song and brightened my day. Who'd have believed that you'd be part of a dream? Now it all seems light years away. And now you know I can't smile without you. I can't smile without you. I can't laugh and I can't sing. I'm finding it hard to do anything.
Born Carol Klein in New York, she also went to school with another major Jewish icon, musical icon, called Paul Simon of Simon and Garfunkel. The musical Beautiful was written all about her life and career. I'm talking about the Carol King.
You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you gotta do is call,
and I'll be there, yes I will, you gotta fail.
Our next Jewish icon comes from this side of the pond. He wrote the wonderful score for Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. His second wife was Dame Joan Collins, who incidentally isn't Jewish. I'm talking about Mr. Anthony Newley.
What kind of fool am I who never fell in love? It seems that I'm the only one that I have been thinking of. What kind of man is this? An empty shell, a lonely cell in which an empty heart must dwell.
What
What kind of lips are these that lied with every kiss, that whispered empty words of love, that left me alone like this? Why can't I fall in love like any other man? And maybe then I'll know what kind of fool I am.
Our next performer sold millions of records as a performer, but he also wrote over 500 songs. If you were around in the 50s or 60s, boy, you would know him. I'm talking about a fantastic guy called Neil Sedaka.
Breaking up is hard to do.
They say that breaking up is hard to do. Now I know that it's true. Don't say that this is the end. Instead of breaking up, I wish that we were making up again. I beg of you, don't say goodbye. Won't you give our love another try? Come on, baby, let's start anew. 'Cause breaking up is hard to do. From one Neil to another, this next one was actually named the Jewish Elvis. Now, he wrote this next song, he said back in the day, about Caroline Kennedy, the daughter of the US president. However, only last year, he admitted that he actually wrote it about his wife. Her name is Marsha, but he couldn't think about a three-syllable name, and nothing rhymed with Marsha. So let's sing together Sweet Caroline by Neil Diamond. Come on!
Sweet Caroline.
Good times never seem so good.
So good, so good.
I've been inclined to believe they never would, but now
this next one came as a surprise to us. We had no idea she was Jewish. She was born Alicia Beth Moore, but her real name is...
Pink! Get this party started on a Saturday night. Everybody's waiting for me to arrive. Sending out a message to all of my friends. We'll be looking flashy in our Mercedes Benz. Let's hear you sing, come on.
I'm coming out, so you better get this party started.
I'm coming out, I'm coming.
I'm coming up, so you better get this party started. For our final Jewish icon, she was a Jewish Miskite from Brooklyn, but she then turned out to be the first, the fastest, and the youngest woman to win, to achieve an EGOT. You know what's an EGOT? Emmy, Grammy, Oscar, Tony. She is my personal favorite. She is Barbara Streisand.
People who need people
are the luckiest people in the world.
With one person.
One very special person. A feeling deep in your soul. Said she were half now your whole.
No more hunger and thirst. First be a person who needs people.
singer-songwriter Eytan Mirsky. The MDA, Magen David Adom, are working around the clock to help the injured and wounded, sometimes at great risk of their lives. Please help them help others. Visit BehindTheMirrorOfMusic.com and donate. Thank you.
And now, joining us is legendary star of the stage and screen, Tovah Feldshuh. Over the decades, Tovah has shown her strong Jewish spirit in Gentle, Crazy Ex-Girlfriend, Funny Girl and Pippin, and especially the record-breaking Broadway run of her self-written one-woman show, Golda, on the life of Golda Meir. Tovah is also a strong Jewish rights activist and will give us a talk on Jewish pride and strength.
Well, hello, everyone. My name is Tovah Feldshuh. I'm an actor on Broadway in film and television. I'm a hometown girl of New York City. And let's talk about Hanukkah. First of all, I am wearing my Hanukkah pants. I don't know if you can see them, because I was at a Hanukkah party at the Jewish Community Center for two of my four grandchildren, Sydney Mae Kirk Levy, age 3, and Amelia Kirk Levy, age I think 17 months. And we had a wonderful time. The reason it is so terrific to discuss Hanukkah is not only because it's a holiday we and the children love, and it also counterbalances the huge celebration in America for Christmas, though Christmas has gotten more and more commercial and less religious in my time on this earth, at least in this wonderful democratic and capitalistic country of the United States. But the reason it is so appropriate to discuss it now is that we survived it. The Jewish people were up against a formidable enemy, the Greek and Syrian Empire, who wanted to change our identity, make us bow to the many gods they had, in other words, introduce idol worship into our daily practices as opposed to Judaic values of Menschlichkeit, the shining of the human soul, the preservation of life. To lose a life is to lose the universe. I think the Jews are dedicated to live while living, to create a rainbow life, because we understand the threat of annihilation, which is what we are up against now with Hamas. For all of you listening, and particularly for all of you wonderful Jewish lefties, I am a liberal Democrat in the city of New York, but listen carefully to make sure that you make a distinction between Hamas and the innocent Palestinian people who are being used as cannon fodder for Hamas. Also, please note that in 2005, these innocent Palestinians voted Hamas into power, and they have never stepped down. In their covenant itself, Article 5 is their dedication to the annihilation of the state of Israel. From the land to the sea, may Palestine be free, which means Judenfrei, free of Jews. So if you have a moral compass, and you are a Jew or a Christian or somebody of the Islamic religion or a Hindu or a Buddhist, I ask you now to speak out. Judah Maccabee spoke out with his body and his mind and his mouth. And against all odds, the Jewish people succeeded in surviving and rededicating their wonderful temples away from all the Greek gods, from Aphrodite and Zeus, and back to monotheism and the idea that God is omniscient, omnipotent, and omnipresent. So I invite you to be a person of moral courage. I can tell you now, the silence at the UN for the women who have been raped, murdered, burned, beheaded, and kidnapped, the Israeli women, has been deafeningly silent, if that's a word, deafeningly, the adverb, silent. And on December the 5th, which is tomorrow, and I know that when this gets broadcast, this will be in the past, but many, many of us are going to the UN right now, tomorrow morning, to be briefed on this silence and to awaken the UN. What else can I tell you? We have survived the Shoah. We have survived Hanukkah. And we will survive this. But there is no way that Israel can survive living next to an ISIS state on either border. So one must do what one must have to do to survive. Who writes a covenant that is dedicated to the annihilation of another people? And Hamas has been very clear. They want genocide. They want to kill us all. And I can tell you, those of us who are listening who happen not to be Jewish, if they should ever win, and they won't, the Jews are only their first stop. You guys are next. Now, to something a little more uplifting, we hope. Fear and Hope by Rabbi Karen Kedar. Inside the human heart is fear, but there is also hope. The two wrestle constantly, like Jacob and his God. Sometimes one prevails, sometimes the other. The struggle is sometimes silent, other times loud, but it is constant. Fear, hope, fear, hope, fear, hope, fear, hope. Flashes of light and shadow twirling inside us all the time. It is so much easier when there is love. When love is in your life, it becomes the context for it all. Love is the measure of a life well lived. It is the beacon of possibility. When you love, the fear is less harsh and the hope a bit stronger. I think that's a very good poem. Hatikva. As long as within our hearts the Jewish soul sings, as long as forward to the east, to Zion, looks the eye, our hope is not yet lost. It is 2,000 years old to be a free people in our land, the land of Zion and Jerusalem. Let me repeat that. To be a free people in our land, the land of Zion and Jerusalem. I don't think there's anything a Jew would want better than to go to the beach and read a book. We're people of the book. We want peace. We value human life. We do not worship death and martyrdom and meeting 72 virgins if you have the privilege of killing Jews. And we have all this on tape, all this recorded. Hamas calling home to their mothers and fathers and proudly saying how many Jews they killed that day. So this is not a war of land. This is a war between civilizations. Western values, the values of democracy, and Sharia law and global jihad. So if there's global jihad, a lot of us would be disappeared. A lot of us. So don't disappear yourself. Let your voice be heard. Be courageous. Let's bring them home. And let's be proud and enjoy being Jewish. How many people can say they belong to a club that's 5,000 years old? I know I'm quoting the lunar calendar. You're part of that club. You're part of the birth of monotheism. You're part of the birth of the ideation without idol worship. You're part of the birth of an intellectual tradition, a rabbinic tradition that became the Harvard, the Yale, the Oxford, the Cambridge, lawyers, doctors, professors. And if you don't speak out, you are complicit. If you don't speak out, you are complicit. I believe it was Einstein. Just give me a moment to locate it. It was Einstein who said, it's a rather famous quote, and I'd rather not disserve it by saying it, by paraphrasing it. Come on now. I got this. Yes. This says, the world will not be destroyed by those who do evil, but by those who watch them without doing anything. Don't let yourself be one of the silent people. Don't. Just think what silence did to us during the Shoah. Stand up and join the values of Western civilization, which are the values of Judaism.
You have enjoyed this lovely night of Hanukkah, together with loved ones far away or nearby. And I hope that you have donated or will donate to the MDA. From all of us, thank you very much. Good night.